Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Good morning, everybody. Good morning to you all. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. May the Almighty God bless you all this morning. May the Almighty God shine His face upon you all this morning. May the Almighty God release the blessings, because the Bible says we are daily loaded with benefits according to the book of Psalms. So today, I decree and I declare into your lives that you are loaded today with benefit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Today is another wonderful Sunday, another glorious Sunday, a perfect Sunday, a good Sunday that the Almighty God in heaven Himself has made for you and I to rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So today, I will be talking on the issue on faith. The issue on faith. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Many people don't understand why God says without faith, it is very, very impossible to please God. Faith is what we need now in this end time. Faith to overcome. Faith to break through. Faith to do the impossible. Faith in God. Faith in Christ is all you and I need now. Hallelujah. The present dispensation now, the present world we are living right now, the present time we are living right now, what we need now is faith. Glory be to God. What we need now is faith. We need strong faith, not just faith, but strong faith. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Most of the time, the situation that people go through may not correspond with what God is talking about. Hallelujah. The situation people go through may not correspond. The situations of life may not correspond what correspond to what the Bible says. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. 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 I said the situation that you may be facing may not correspond with what God is talking about. How do I mean? For example, amen, you have been praying. You have been praying. You say, God, I need this particular breakthrough. I need this particular breakthrough. I want to break through in my finance. Or I want to break through in my body. I want to break through in my work. I want to be promoted in my work. I want to go to the next level in my work. I want to do this. I want to do that. You have been praying. Hallelujah. And you believe in that prayer. And it's for you to get to work. You that have been praying, you need promotion. You want to be promoted in your work. You get to your working place, they give you a sack letter. Hallelujah. You see that? Is there not a situation there? Hallelujah. You have been praying, God, I need a promotion. I need a promotion. You have been doing all kinds of things. You have been fasting. You have been praying. You have been sowing seed because you need a promotion in your job. And all you can get when you get to your job is just after a week of that prayer, you are giving a sack letter to be, you are sacked from that job. So what do? In that situation, you need strong faith. Hallelujah. That is why I said most of the time, what you want to get may not correspond with what God is talking in this world, in the Bible. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For example, you'll be praying, oh God, I want to break through financially. Oh God, I want to have this, I want to have that. Oh God, I want to, you have been praying, you have been fasting, you have been sowing seed for that, you know, financial breakthrough. And all of a sudden is to see that at the end of the month, you cannot even pay your bills. You cannot even pay your rent or your mortgage. You can't even pay your water bill, your electricity bill. You can't even pay your children's school fees. Hallelujah. You that have been praying, amen, that you want financial breakthrough, and you so much, you know, I rely on the financial breakthrough, is to see that at the end of the month, everywhere is so dry. You can't even, you will find it very difficult to eat. Hallelujah. That is where you need strong faith. So this morning, I'm talking about issues like that. I'm talking about strong faith. Amen. You don't need faith when everything is okay. You don't need strong faith when you are breaking through left, right, front, back. You don't need strong faith when things are just okay for you. That is why I'm making these strong examples. You know, the two examples I've just made. You know, you've been praying for breakthrough, financial breakthrough, financial breakthrough, financial breakthrough. And all of a sudden is to say at the end of the month, you cannot even pay your bills. You can't even do anything. Amen. And you so much just rely on, oh, now the financial breakthrough is coming. Financial breakthrough is coming. Ah, by the end of this month, I'm going to break through, really. And at the end of the month, you see that the breakthrough is not coming. You can't even do anything. Amen. No, you pray for your work. you know, to be promoted. It's for you to get a job, they sack you. Amen. So people like this need strong faith. You need strong faith. Complaining is not the issue. Complaining is not the issue. Look at Abraham. Hallelujah. Look at Abraham. Abraham, look at what Abraham went through. Abraham used his faith. He used his faith. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Now, hallelujah. Now, what is strong faith? Strong faith is when you are facing negative situation, impossible situation. When you are facing impossible situation, you need strong faith. Hallelujah. When you are praying for something to happen, and it happens that, you know, the negative side came to pass. You are praying for positive answers in your life, and you see that negativities are coming. So what do? You need strong faith. That is not the time to complain. That is not the time to be blaming God or be asking God. That is not the time to be talking about the church or against the church. That is not the time to be talking against the servants of God or the pastors. That is not the time to complain at all. It is the time to demonstrate your faith. It is the time to put your faith to work. It is the time to believe that God is who He says He is. It is the time to release your faith. You know, it is the time to release your faith. Faith is for those that are, you know, that are really down. Faith is for those that, you know, that, you know, is really facing impossible situation. When you are going through impossible situation and you release your faith, I am telling you, every situation will give way. You know, I always say to people, what you are afraid of losing is what you will eventually lose. Don't be afraid of anything. Don't be afraid of any situation. When you are praying for breakthrough and you see that negative things are happening, release your faith. Release your faith. You need strong faith. Hallelujah. When you release your faith in that situation, you will see that nothing will be impossible for you. Nothing will be impossible for you. Strong faith does not stagger. Does not stagger. When you are praying for a promotion in your working place, and you get there, they give you a sack letter to get out of the job. Collect the letter and go home and start praising God. Collect the letter and go home and start worshiping God. And start declaring, as far as you like that place, you start declaring in the name of Jesus. They have just given me a holiday. In the name of Jesus, I'm just on holiday. By this time next month, I'm going back to my job. In the name of Jesus, not just going back to my job, but going back promoted. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare that is my place of work. Not just if I go back now, after this holiday, you will call that sack letter a holiday. After my holiday right now, when I get back to that working place, I'll be promoted. In the name of Jesus. Let me tell you, strong faith does not stagger. Strong faith releases power in the face of negativity. Strong faith releases, you know, releases work actions. It goes into action in the face of negativity. Strong faith is what you and I need now. It's not complain. It is not time to complain. Abraham did not complain. Abraham did not complain. Joseph did not complain. Hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty. Strong faith is what you need now. Strong faith is what you need now. Don't complain. Don't ask God why. Don't ask God why not. Don't ask God any question. When you are praying for something and it's not going through, and the negative side of that thing happen, oh my God, that is when you need to decree and declare. You stand by the word of God that says nothing is impossible for those that believe. Nothing is impossible for those that believe. What are you believing God for? Are you believing God for the fruit of the womb? Are you believing God to be married to the right spouse? Are you believing God to break through financially? Are you believing God for that job to be promoted? In the name of Jesus, I say it is possible for you. Just release your faith. Don't stagger. Strong faith does not stagger. Strong faith is a very stubborn faith. Very, very stubborn. Hallelujah. Strong faith is a faith that will say no when it's supposed to be yes. Hallelujah. It's no. When you get a negativity in any situation, strong faith is that kind of stubborn faith that does not give up. Hallelujah. Have you been dealing with some people that are very stubborn? Have you not come across people that are very stubborn? Very, have you not heard people say, this person is very stubborn? He doesn't listen. Have you not heard people say like that? That should be your faith. Hallelujah. You say no to the enemy. You say no to that negative situation. You say no. You stand by your word. You stand by what you have declared. You stand by the word of God. You stand by what you believe that you want to get. You stand to say, this is my stand in this particular breakthrough. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Strong faith is a very stubborn faith. It's a very, very stubborn faith. Hallelujah. So if any Christian should be stubborn, we should be stubborn to the things that, you know, we want to achieve, the positive things that pleases God, that we want to achieve in our lives. So if the enemy is trying to stop us from our breakthrough, if the enemy is trying to take us out of our breakthrough, we should release our faith. We should be stubborn to the enemy and say, no, this is my right. Hallelujah. The Bible says it is the will of God for you to prosper, even as your soul prospereth. The Bible says, wherever the sole of your feet shall tread on, you shall possess. So if you are that in that walking place and the enemies want to send you out, or the enemies are playing with you, you know, you tell the enemy that you've got God on your side, you've got God inside of you, who is bigger than everything or every situation in life, and you begin to claim and possess that working place. Before you know it, you will become what you are saying. Hallelujah. The Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. So when you keep on declaring and believing, you keep on believing, you do not stagger. Be stubborn. Hallelujah. Be stubborn. That is when a Christian should be stubborn. A Christian, when you know, a Christian should be stubborn when it comes to situations like that. Hallelujah. That is where Christian releases stubbornness. Amen. Say no to the devil. Devil, you are under my feet. This is what I want, and this is what I want. You go for it. Hallelujah. With the help of God Almighty, you will break through. Glory be to God. Strong faith is a very stubborn faith. Hallelujah. We can see how Jesus demonstrated it in the time of Lazarus. Remember, when the people came to tell Jesus, they said, Jesus, Lazarus, your best friend, is dead. What did Jesus say? Jesus said, he's not dead, he's sleeping. Hallelujah. He said, he's sleeping. That is what I said to you just now. When they give you a sack letter, collect it from them, go home and start praising God. You call that sack letter a holiday term. Hallelujah. You can just give yourself 1 month. Say, oh, this 1 month I'm going to relax. Glory be to God. And you begin to possess that place. I tell you, after 1 month that you declare, they will call you back. Glory be to God. Not just only calling you back, they promote you. Hallelujah. So look at our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Look at what he demonstrated. He demonstrated it. He showed to us that we need faith. He showed to us that this is what we need now. Let me tell you, without faith, the reason why many Christians are crying, the reason why many Christians are losing, is because they are not releasing their faith. You need strong faith. You don't just need just faith. Like, you need a strong faith. Hallelujah. 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 You need strong faith. What did Jesus do? When they came to tell Jesus, they said, Jesus, your friend Lazarus, you know, your friend Lazarus is dead. Jesus said, he is not dead, but he's sleeping. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. What did Jesus do? Jesus waited until they buried Lazarus, until Lazarus was in the grave for 4 days. And after then, Jesus went there. Hallelujah. Lazarus was buried for 4 days. He was in the grave for 4 days. And Jesus now went there. And when Jesus got there, he just called Lazarus comfort. Hallelujah. And immediately Lazarus rose from the dead. Glory be to God. What a strong faith is this. So what is dead in your life? What is it that you want to achieve and you are not getting? Use your faith. Call it forth in the name of Jesus. If Jesus did it, Jesus said, greater works will you do. Greater works will you do. So if Jesus called Lazarus out of the grave in after 4 days that Lazarus died, remember, after 4 days, he's already smelling. He's already smelling. The body's already decayed. Hallelujah. Listen, that very verse in the Bible, don't play with it. Don't just throw it into the bin. Use it. It's very, very important. Vital, important. Hallelujah. It's very, very crucial. It's very, very important for every believer to work on. It's very, very important for every believer to take and begin to use. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Jesus said to them, go home. Lazarus is sleeping. Hallelujah. Imagine a person that is dead. He's dead already. Jesus said he's sleeping. Glory be to God. He said he's sleeping. That is faith, because Jesus believed. He believed that the power All powers on earth and in heaven have been given to him. And let me tell you, when Jesus was going, he didn't go with that power. He left the power with us. Even greater power, because he said, I will go to my Father. And when I go to my Father, the Holy Ghost will come upon you. So it means that every child of God that truly serves God in truth and the Spirit carries the Holy Ghost. When you carry the Holy Ghost, you cannot fail. When you carry the Holy Ghost, you cannot be down. When you carry the Holy Ghost, nobody can rightfully take what belongs to you from you. If you carry the Holy Ghost, nobody can bring you down. If you carry the Holy Ghost, let me tell you, you will decree anything or declare anything. You must surely have what you say. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. If you carry the Holy Ghost, the faith, you know, your faith should be activated, because the Holy Ghost is not a failure. The Holy Ghost is not, it's not a small personality. He's the greatest personality in the whole world. He's the greatest power, the greatest force in the whole world. So when you carry the Holy Ghost, when the Holy Ghost is at work in your life, all things will be possible for you. So it's not left for you. The Holy Ghost can't do anything without you cooperating. Hallelujah. When you release your faith, you stand by your faith, all things will be possible for you. You will begin to break through left, right, front, back. Hallelujah. You will be a smiling person, a person that is always smiling, a person that is always, you know, I don't know how to put it to you anymore. Glory be to God. Look at what Jesus did. They came to tell him. They said, your friend Lazarus is dead. He said, he's sleeping. So tell me what happened when Jesus got there on the fourth day. He stood and he said, Lazarus, come forth. Immediately the Bible says Lazarus got up from the grave and walked to Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus said, lose him. Lose all the grave clothes on him, because he's not dead, he's alive. Hallelujah. That finance, that your finance that is constantly going down, speak to your bank account, speak to your finance in the name of Jesus Christ. Speak to your finance. Glory be to God. That walk where you are walking, they say that you cannot stay there. Speak to that ground where you are walking, speak to the land where you are walking in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. That's Jesus Christ. Look at another woman in the Bible, the Shunammite woman. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory, 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 glory. This Shunammite woman, who the Holy Son. You and I know the story of this Shunammite woman. The Shunammite woman. The son was dead, the only son he had. He didn't have two children, he had only one. The son was dead. Everyone was pitying her. Oh, sorry, say, no, it is well. It is well. Don't pity me. It is well. It is well. Hallelujah. What happened at last? Is the child not come back to life? It is well. Hallelujah. That is the language of a child of God. That is the language of a Christian. A Christian is not a person that, you know, wanting people to come and be pitying him or pitying her. What will that bring to you? I always say to people, you know, the word pity has to do with the evil spirit. It's an evil spirit word. It's a demonic word. You know, where people come, a Christian, a child of God, you know, allowing people to, oh, I'm very sorry. Sorry for what happened to you. Oh, sorry. Oh, many Christians want people to pity them. May God not allow you to get that spirit of allowing people to pity you in the name of Jesus. Look at the Shunammite woman. Who the son died. The son died. She acted like Jesus. Look at, if this Shunammite woman, if people are saying, okay, it was Jesus, Jesus, what about the Shunammite woman? The Shunammite woman is just a woman like you and I. It's just a person like you and I. Hallelujah. It's a man like you and I. It's a woman like you and I, who has just two eyes, two nose, one mouth, you know, one head, and two hands, and just normal human being. Glory be to God. The son died. And what did the woman say? The woman said, it is well. When people are coming to pity, I say, don't pity me. Don't pity me. I don't like that. Hallelujah. It is well. She keeps smiling. It is well. It is well. I say it is well today with your soul in the name of Jesus. Whatever is dead in your life, whatever is not working well in your life, every turbulence is in your life today, I decree the power and the spirit of it is well into your life in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Shunammite woman said it is well. And really, let me tell you, the son came back to life supernaturally. Glory be to God Almighty. Glory, 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 glory. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Amen. Glory be to God Almighty. You know, amen. When we go to the book of John 11:41, the book of John. John chapter 11, verse 41. Hallelujah. John chapter 11, verse 41. Look at what it says. John chapter 11. He said, then they took away the stones from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. You see, he's talking about Lazarus. Hallelujah. When Jesus went there, after calling Lazarus forth, Lazarus came back and Jesus lifted up his head and thanked the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, a child of God never brings his or her head down. A child of God never complains. A child of God, you know, smile up all the time. In any situation, any circumstances, a child of God is an overcomer. Hallelujah. Not just overcomer, even more than overcomer. The Bible says you are more than overcomer. Ha! If there are no situations in your life, how can you overcome? Do you know what that word means? More than overcomer. That simply means that things will happen. Negative things will happen. But when you now use your strong faith, when you overcome, it means that you are more than overcomer. Ha! Not just overcomer, but more than. The Bible says you are more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. How can you be more than a conqueror when you did not fight any war? Glory be to God. So you can see that the life we are living. Christians, stop complaining. Stop complaining. Stop blaming people for anything. Jesus says you are more than overcomer. You are more than conquerors. So it means that to be more than a conqueror means that there are fights you are going to fight. There are fights you are going to fight. There are things you are going to overcome. When you now overcome that situation, it means that you have been made more than overcomer. Hallelujah. If there are no fights, if there are no situations that you will overcome, Jesus wouldn't have said, the word of God wouldn't have said that you are more than a conqueror or you are more than overcomer. Hallelujah. Because there are fights you are going to fight. There are wars you are going to fight. But in all that, Jesus said, cheer up, for he has made you more than conqueror. Hallelujah. He said, cheer up, for he has overcome the world. Jesus Christ has overcome the world. But for you to live on a daily basis, you know, fulfilling your destiny, you need to release your strong faith to what Jesus Christ has done. You release your strong faith knowing fully that Jesus has overcome the world. There is no situation in the world that Jesus has not overcome. But for you to enjoy what Jesus Christ has done, you need to release your strong faith. Just like that Shunammite woman, she said, it is well. When her daughter died, okay, which situation would be more than that? Which situation would be more than that? For example, you don't have money in your pocket. Or for example, you don't have food to eat. You might, okay, tomorrow you might have money. Tomorrow you might have food to eat, you know. Or when you are sacked from one job, tomorrow you might get another job. But when a child died, there is no hope of having that child back tomorrow. I think death is the highest that can happen to a human being. Losing a child or losing someone that is very dear to you is the worst thing that can happen to a person. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But in that, you know, when this Shunammite woman experienced the highest calamity in her life, she said, it is well. It is well. Hallelujah. Remember, God did not put her to shame. She said, it is well. And really, for sure, everything became well. The child came back to life. You know, the woman, you know, she was so blessed and that she was living a fulfilled life. So it's the same thing I'm telling you today, brothers and sisters. It's the same thing I'm telling you today, all Christians all over the world. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, anywhere you are, it is well with your soul. It is well with your soul. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. And let's go again to the book of that same John 11 verse 4. 11 verse 4. John 11 verse 4. John 11 verse 4. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Oh, I love this so much. I just told you, listen, children of God, every situation you are going through is to the glory of God, not for you to complain. Every situation you are going through is to the glory of God. They give you a sack letter to stop that job. It's to the glory of God. Whatever it is, you are sick in your body, is to the glory of God. God wants to glorify himself in that situation. That is the reason why you need strong faith. That is the reason why you need faith. You need faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. If you are going through any situation, don't complain. That situation is to the glory of God. Let me read this to you again. John chapter 11 verse 4. He says, when Jesus heard that, when they came to Jesus to tell Jesus that, Jesus, your friend Lazarus is sick. Hallelujah. He is sick. What did Jesus? He said he is sick. And he said, the sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified therefore. The sickness is not unto death. It's to the glory of God. Hallelujah. That situation that is just occurring and reoccurring and reoccurring is not to bring you down. God wants you to release your faith. God wants you to release your faith. He wants you to use your faith so that his name will be glorified. Hallelujah. God wants you to release your faith so that the people out there, so that the people in the world will know that your God is a big God. So God allowed that situation so that the whole world will see that you are going through this situation. And when you release your faith in the name of Jesus Christ, you will overcome. And when you now overcome, it means that you have not made more than overcomer. And the name of God will be glorified. Many people will come to God because of that miracle. So that is the reason why God permits a lot of things. It's not to put you to shame. It's not to make you, it's not to put you to shame. And it's not to make you, not to make you down. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God Almighty. Hallelujah. 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 Glory be to God. Your faith is needed in the time of any situation. Your faith is needed in the time of any situation. Release your faith to the glory of God. Release your faith to the glory of God. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus said that sickness is not unto death. Today, I agree with the word of God. I agree with the Holy Ghost and I agree with Jesus. That situation you are going through is not unto death. That situation you are going through is not to bring shame to you. That situation you are going through is to lift up the name of God. That situation you are going through, people are laughing at you that you are not going to amount to anything. God is about to step in and change your story. God is about to wipe away your tears. So brothers and sisters, stay in put. Don't be shaken. Release your strong faith. It doesn't matter what is happening. Believe that God is whom he says he is. Hallelujah. He said, call upon me in the day of trouble and I will answer you and I will show you great and mighty things. It doesn't matter how much hell has broken loose against you. Believe. Don't stagger in your faith. Don't stagger in your faith. Be very stubborn to negativity. Be very stubborn. Say yes. Say yes to every positive situation in your life. Say yes in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty. Be very, very stubborn. Be very, very stubborn. That is when a Christian is stubborn. Many Christians, they are stubborn to authority. Many Christians, they go to church, you tell them do this, they get angry. Many Christians, when you correct them in the church, they are angry. Many Christians, their pastors cannot even talk to them. When their pastors talk to them, they want to blow the sky loose. When their pastors correct them or when they are corrected in the church, they are angry. Some will even leave the church because they are angry. Hallelujah. Many Christians, you cannot talk to them. When you talk to them, they get angry. They get angry. They are very stubborn. That is not when you should be stubborn. You are stubborn to your pastor. You are stubborn to church authority. You are stubborn to who is correcting you, who wants better things for you. But you have a lot of situation. You should release your faith. Say no. Be stubborn to that situation. Not to be stubborn to the church or to be stubborn to the authorities of God or to be stubborn to things that can help you in life. When you need to be stubborn is when your situation is persisting in your life that is not supposed to be there. You know, you begin to decree and declare, say no, not to Satan, not to Satan, not to poverty, not to sickness. That is stubborn faith. You say no to sickness. I cannot be sick. I cannot be sick. Hallelujah. I cannot be sick. When Jesus died, I died with him. When Jesus resurrected, I resurrected with him. So every sickness died with Jesus. When Jesus resurrected as a brand new person, I resurrected with him. So I am made brand new. In the name of Jesus, I cannot be sick. You say no, you be stubborn to that sickness and command that sickness to go. If you are a person that is always broke, you don't have money, you don't have money, you say no poverty. Because the Bible says, you know, he said, Jesus made himself poor so that you will be rich. Hallelujah. So these are the areas where Christian needs stubbornness. When you are stubborn to poverty, you say, no, poverty, you can't dwell in me. You have no place in me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am like Christ. Jesus Christ owns the silver and gold. So I am. As he is in heaven, so I am. Be stubborn to things like this, and you will see you will break through. You will break through. Hallelujah. If you are not stubborn to things like this, and you are only stubborn to, you are stubborn to the church, you are stubborn to your pastors, you are stubborn to your parents, you are stubborn to, you know, your family, you are stubborn to, you know, you can't make anything. You can't make anything. The only time a child of God should be stubborn is to Satan. Say no to negativity that Satan is bringing your way. And say yes to Jesus. Say yes to to what Jesus Christ has said. Hallelujah. 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 Let us follow the examples of Jesus Christ. Let us follow the example of the Shunammite woman. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Remember when they came to Jesus and tell Jesus that the Lazarus is sick. He said that sickness is not unto death, but to the glory of God. And eventually, Lazarus died. Even after the pronunciation of Jesus Christ, he died physically. But that did not shake the faith of Jesus. Remember, that's what I'm trying to put across to you. That did not shake the faith of Jesus. Even after Jesus said, that sickness is not unto death. But what happened? Lazarus still eventually died. But it didn't shake the faith of Jesus. No, it didn't shake him. It didn't shake him because Jesus knows that he got something inside of him, you know, to raise him up. And that is faith. That is faith. It's no more than that. It's faith. Hallelujah. And when they came, they said, Jesus, God, you said that sickness is not unto death. But Lazarus still died. He still died. Hallelujah. And Jesus went there after 4 days. And he said, Lazarus, come forth. And the people went, huh? What? This man, what he said? It's the same thing. He has given us the same power. Hallelujah. That's what I said. If you are praying for a job, you are praying for a breakthrough, and the negative side happens, don't give up. Stand on your declaration. And when you stand on it, you will break through. Just like Jesus. He said that sickness is not unto death. And before you know it, Lazarus died. Did Jesus shake in his faith? Say, huh? But I said it's not unto death. Why did he do that? Jesus did not say that. He did not say that. He still relaxed. He did his job where he was doing his job. When he finished, he went there. He said, take me there. They took him there. He saw the grave where they laid Lazarus. And he said, Lazarus, come forth. And he came forth. So if you are praying for something, you are believing God for a breakthrough, and negative things begin to happen, don't be staggered. Don't shake. Stand input on what you believe and begin to declare it. Call forth your miracles. Call forth your breakthroughs in the name of Jesus. Call forth everything you want and you will have it like Jesus. Glory be to God. May the Almighty God bless us this morning. May the Almighty God shine his face. We are just preparing to go to church this morning. I just decided to make the video because today we have a lot of activities in the church. We have 2 children to dedicate today in the church. So we just decided to make the video very quickly before we go to church because today, I don't know what time we are going to close. 2 children for dedication today in the church. Dedication, 2 children. So, I don't know exactly when we are going to close. So, I just decided to make this video in my home before I leave. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We just see the keyboardist. My first son just passed going to the church. He's the one that played the keyboard. Glory be to God Almighty. So, may the Almighty God bless you all as you enjoy this word on strong faith.